हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. सो दिस इज लिटिल एडवांस एंड इन दिस वे यू विल लर्न वेरी इजीली वेनेला जावा स्क्रिप्ट. इट मीन्स कोर जावा स्क्रिप्ट. सो कोर जावा स्क्रिप्ट इज इन डिमांड. ओके, बिकॉज लॉट्स ऑफ पीपल आर यूजिंग लॉट्स ऑफ फ्रेमवर्क, सो दे आर मिसिंग द कोर जावा स्क्रिप्ट लैंग्वेज. बट समटाइम्स इट्स वेरी वेरी यूजफुल. सो दैट्स वाई आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू जनरेट डायनेमिकली अ रो. सो इन दिस वे यू विल लर्न इन डीपर अबाउट द जावा स्क्रिप्ट. सो एज यू कैन सी, वेन एवर आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस एड बटन, देन वन रो इज जनरेटिंग एंड इन ईच रो देयर आर वन फील्ड ऑल्सो एंड वन बटन. सो suppose I am selecting here United States and I am going to remove this row. So whenever I will click this remove button, then that row is removed. So how to achieve this functionality using core vanilla JavaScript? So let's try to do it, and definitely you will enjoy this video. So it's my recommendation is to please watch this video till the end. It's very important, otherwise you will miss lots of things. This video is very useful and very informative for the beginner and those who want to learn advanced JavaScript. So it is very important. So let's begin. We can also check the functionality from this console. So let's try. Now as you can see that we are going to select this element, which is their ID is add the filter dynamically. So we can use here because now we move from the body to move to the division, this one, and then this division, and here I am selecting the division which ID is something, this one, which is add field dynamically. If there are lots of field division, then in that case we can select a particular division in this way. However, without using the query selector, we can also select this this div tag using document.getElement by ID, because ID is also a unique selector, so we can easily select it. But in case there are no ID, then in that case this will be useful. So in place of ID, if this is a class, then we need to do here this will be a dot. So now since this is a division, I am going to fill with some space. So NBSP, as you know that we are using NBSP to provide some space. And now again refresh, so you can see that there are the red border. Why this red color is coming from? Because this comes from this division, and their style, their background color is changed due to our query selector. We have selected this division which ID have add field dynamically, and then applying some style which have a background color red. That's why here the background color is red are coming. So in place of ID, if you want to use a class, so we can also use, for example, if you write class here, and because the class is denoted here as a dot, that's why we need to provide here the dot. And again I am refreshing, so as you can see there are no changes because this dot is also working properly fine. Sometimes during the query selector, if you want to select some element, you can use some style, some background style, so that you can identify that right element got selected or not. So in this way you can identify. That's why I am showing you. As you can see that we are going to append something which is basically a table and which have a tr, and the tr is one row. So for writing a row we are using the tr, and they and under the tr it have some column, so that's why we are providing here. So the first tr td have some select box. So this select box is a country, and this is going to be they have some value. So there are the certain value that I am providing here statically. So let's check that it's working perfectly fine or not. So since you can see here that it's append, but we need to append the HTML. So as you can see here that for the inner.html we need to write in the means is equal to something in this way. That's why it's not basically a function, it's storing the value here for the inner HTML. So once I'll refresh, I got it. These two option is added here dynamically. So now I am going to put these things in a functions. Now as you can see that we have called these functions, and basically these functions are generating this select box. So if you will inspect, you will find that there are the tr and there are their id. Tr have a id and the select box is also have id, and it's appended with one, because my goal is to, if you will click the add button, then if another row will be generated with the same field, then in that case this id should be changed, because id should be unique, and through this unique id we can do many things. That's why we are trying to kept the thing unique. That's why whenever we will add a new row, then their id will be unique. So as you can see, this with the unique id this one row is generated. And now let's try to add some other functionality. Now I wanted to change the functionality. The functionality should be that whenever we will click this row, then that will should be deleted. And if you want to add a new row, then it should be on the bottom of the table. So just quickly I am going to do some other functionality. So here instead of saying add, here I am doing remove, as you can see. And then you can see here that whenever we will click, then that particular row should be removed. So now we are going to achieve this functionality. And for the adding the new row, we will add here a button at the below. So we will add here at the place of table. So as you know that we have done something wrong here, which is the inner HTML. What inner HTML is doing is to replacing the previous element and adding the new element. So instead of doing this, we need to add the append. But the disadvantage of the append is that we need to create the tag manually. It's also called DOM manipulation. So as you can see that we are using tr and all these things, so we need to manually create. So let's try to create. Now as you can see that when we click add, then automatically row is generating because we are adding the click event, add event, listener whenever we will click, and basically we are selecting with the ID. So after selecting we are calling the event listener, and then here calling this functions. Or basically what function is doing is to generating creating the tr element and then appending this td. Now we need to remove this remove the whenever we will click on this remove button, then this row should be removed. So let's now this functionality is working perfectly fine. Whenever we will click on this add button, then a new row is generating, and whenever we will click on the remove, then right element, right row is deleting. So here I am selecting the United States. Why? So that we can identify that right row is deleting or not, and whenever we will click, then it's removed. It means it is working fine. Now we need to add some color of the button. So let's use some bootstrap classes here. Now as you can see that we have added some buttons, means remove button is here the in the red color, and in the blue color it's add. So now you can see that this functionality is working fine. So we can look at the code, how this code is working. Here is the body. You see, it is a simple body, it's HTML, and then one division. This is the container fluid. We are using container fluid. It's a bootstrap classes, and now again I am replacing, it's a little shift because we have used here the container. So according to the margin of the classes, depending upon as per the class there are certain margin, and this due to this it shift. And now whenever we are clicking, then new row is generating. How it's possible? So let's we can format this HTML. So basically where here one division are available which have classes add filled dynamically, right? And now here we have a selector from body is a parent, and then we are moving to the child, and then again we are moving to the another child which is this div, and again we are selecting which class is at filled dynamically. As you can see that if there will be lots of division, then we can select a particular division in this way, right? And now we are appending something, we are changing something, because right now it's a empty division, it have only the space, but we are replacing with a certain element. So we are adding some table. You can see here their ID is something table through JavaScript, and some tr and other stuff. Basically this tr is it's basically a button. So this tr is providing the button, and this is here. at the top. And now the table is created. The table have a ID, certain ID, which is this one. Whenever we will click on this button, then button have also ID, which is the add new row. So here we are selecting this button. You can see here document.getElementById and add event listener. What this add event listener is do to whenever any event will be fire, it means click. Here I am writing here the click, and for the on change and mouse over there are lots of event, but since this is a button, whenever we will click, then another function will be get fired, and these functions are fired and another function will call. And basically this another function is creating a new row. It's new row. So for creating a new row, we have generated a tr, means row, HTML tr. So document.createElement, it means tr is tr element get created. And after creating, we have also providing some attribute. So as you can see that we are using set attribute and providing ID and make it dynamically. That's why we have providing ID and appending some number, so that the each ID will be unique, and whenever we will required to select the right element, we can select through this ID. That's why we have provided here. And now you can see here that the number is incremented, number is added here. We have done the inner HTML to within this tr element we are providing some td, means so this td have one td have a select box and another td have one button, which is the remove button, as you can see. And again their id is appending with the unique number. That's why whenever new row will be generated, then id will be different, so that we can in the future we can select the right element whenever it's required. So in this way it is working. After getting all these things, we are appending this value to this table. So as you can see, the document.getElementById, and through this ID we are here appending the new element. Basically new element is a new row, and in this way new row is generating. Now whenever we will remove this button, then what happened that on click, we are writing here the on click is the functions, and this function will get fired, which is the remove row. And passing, it means this element is passing, means this is the button. So since this element means button is get passed, then here we are using parent element, so that we can select their td, and again we will do the parent element, then we will go move to the tr. So now we move to the tr, and since we removed, we use the JavaScript function to remove that tr. In this way tr got removed. So as you can see, this functionality are working, and we are writing here the vanilla JS. It means core JavaScript, where here there are no jQuery and no any framework. So we can also achieve all these things through the JavaScript, core vanilla JavaScript. But you can see that it's look lengthy because there are lots of code for the simple functionality. So this code get generated to do this functionality. I hope you understand. If you will face any problem, then let us know. My purpose is to make it some certain complication in the project. That's why you can understand whenever you will work on the real project, then you might face this type of real situation. That's why I try to make it. So I hope you understand.